Ethereum is in a difficult spot here, but it's not over yet. Good morning from Stockholm, Sweden. To understand what is really going on with Ethereum, we have to look at not only the Ethereum chart, but also what is going on with the other altcoins, Solana, BNB, and even Cardano. But most of all, of course, what's going on with Bitcoin. Let's dive into it. If we look at the ETH-USD chart first. As you recall, Lars and Line turned blue, meaning down here, on 3rd January 2022, at about 3,800. Then interestingly, we found support on this line, 2,900. Look here, in May 2021, it was a strong resistance. We tried several times to get over, and then finally broke through here. And then approximately that level provided support here in September 2021. And now look here, we got some support at exactly that level at 2,900. And then if you didn't exit at the top, which was frankly quite difficult, and if you didn't exit here, and you didn't exit here, and if you didn't exit at the Lars & Line blue flip, this could be seen as a last line of defense. Because if you look at this chart in isolation, no matter how we draw this parabola, like I draw it originally, or we draw it like this, the parabola is broken here. Lars & Line is down. It's a quite scary looking chart, but selling at support is never the right strategy. So if we didn't sell at any of the previous triggers, I would say that this last line of defense is still worth a try. Maybe it will hold, maybe it will turn up from here, and if it doesn't, maybe that's the time to cut it. But I feel that this is just part of the story. To understand what is going on with Ethereum versus USD, we absolutely have to look at what is happening to the ETH BTC chart and the Bitcoin to USD chart. So let's look at that. Now, Ethereum versus BTC has been best analyzed on the weekly chart, so we continue with that. And as I've mentioned a few times, this breakout attempt from this range failed. We're back into the range, but if we instead interpret this as a symmetrical triangle, it could be a retest. See here, it broke out, bounced. So I don't think this is totally hopeless yet, but we definitely need to see some strength here, which we haven't seen yet lately. That's then half the story, and the other half is definitely Bitcoin to US dollar. And so far, the 40k support has held. This level that has been so important since January 2021, here, and again now in January 2022. Will it hold? Will we get another bounce? Is this the bottom and it turns up from here? No. No one knows, even the guys selling and the guys buying here, knows at this point how this will turn out. If we zoom in a little bit, what we can say with certainty is that the bounce was quite weak. We didn't get the follow through that I was hoping for. We didn't get it. Instead, we got weakness and we're turning back down towards this support. It's not really what I was hoping to see. I was hoping to see a strong bounce, a strong follow through, and a clear turnaround here. We have not got it yet. So I think we have to be cautious still, consider the possibility that this might break through or we might get a bounce here. It's impossible to say at this point, and I think the right thing to do here is to keep an open mind. The next few days or next week or so will be very important for this market. So what will happen to Bitcoin at this 40k support will be very important for the Ethereum price versus USD as well. That much is clear. But what is happening to the other altcoins also gives us clues here. So let's have a look at that. And just like Ethereum, BNB is fairly stable here. Look here, it found support little over 0.01, and it has been fairly stable against Bitcoin for months now. And this is even clearer. It's crazy clear here on the Solana to BTC chart. Look here, the tiny range that Sol to BTC has been in all the way since October last year. And this is important because of this. Typically when the market is scared, there's a flight to safety, which in Bitcoin markets or crypto markets means moving coins from risky altcoins to safe Bitcoin. And as we see here, that has not happened yet. So that leads me to believe that the market isn't that scared after all, despite the weakness that we see in the whole market for the past couple of months. Well, there's even a belief in the altcoins, which is holding back against this fear that's building in the market because of Bitcoin's apparent weakness. And those of you who have been on the channel for some time, maybe you remember this video where I made fun of everyone that were predicting 10k Ethereum by the end of the year. And I hope that by this time you start appreciating the value in not using a predictive method, but instead using a reactive model where we avoid trying to predict the future, but instead try to react to what actually happens. Because as it turns out, predicting the future is surprisingly difficult. And a word of warning again, anyone who approaches you in the comments or elsewhere saying that you can get Lars & Line and my course and everything anywhere else than on ctolarson.com, it is a scam, guys. Don't fall for it. Don't send money to someone else, please. Many of you have asked me to do a separate video on the ADA Cardano situation, and I will do that. I will do that also today, and I will post it later today. So make sure you're subscribed, have the bell on. So to sum up this Ethereum section, it's looking weak, but it's not over yet. And see you later in this video. Thank you, Tuck. CTO Larsen out. Hej då!